Hi everyone, this is Rutraj and welcome to our channel Join. In today's video, we'll be seeing another video of derivative segment, that is futures contract. So similar to option, futures is also another derivative segment contract. So futures, the time is generally near month, next month and far month. So what are these? These are the expiries, okay? Expiries. So say for example, the current month is July, so the near month would be the next month, that is August, and then the next month would be September, and the far month would be October. So you can buy futures contract either of August or of September or of October. So similar to options, here also there would be buyers and sellers. So future buyer and future seller, there are only two aspects. One is future buyer and future seller. Future seller. So what you are saying is that in the month of August, if you are a buyer, you are saying that in the month of August I would be buying at a price, say for example, currently Reliance price is 2000. This is in July. In August, the futures price is, say for example, 2010. You are saying that if the price I would be buying at price 2010 in August, this is the buyer's perspective as per future. So you are saying in future, I would be buying Reliance shares at 2010. Now imagine that if in August actually the Reliance price moved from 2000 to say for example 2050, and in this case you would be making a profit of 40 rupees, right? So this is how the futures contract work. And even the seller wants, seller thinks that seller would be selling at 2010, so the seller thinks that in August the price would be below 2010. So this is the simple future buyer and seller's perspective. Now let's see the margin requirement. Margin. So for buyer and seller both, for buyer and seller both, the margin would be same. It would be the value at risk plus span plus exposure. It would be around, generally per lot, it would be around 3 lakhs per lot in general terms. So this future, you have to do it in lot. You cannot do, you cannot just buy one share of Reliance. You have to do it in lot as say similar to our options, right? So note that the margin required would be around 3 lakh per lot. So now let's see what is this M2M. So M2M is mark to market. So what does that mean? Say for example, today you bought Reliance futures at 2010. Now say for example, today the price moved from 2000, this was today's price, moved from 2000 to 2020, right? So your futures price, August future price was 2010, it would also move by around 20 points. So it would be around 2030, right? Now, what does M2M means? So in the day, you made a profit of 20 rupees. This is your profit, 20 rupees profit, right? So this profit would be credited to your account the same day. right? So what does that mean? You are the buyer and here is the seller. So the initial margin blocked is 3 lakhs. So 3 lakhs margin is blocked, right? Here also 3 lakhs margin is blocked. Now as a buyer, you made a profit of 20 rupees per share, right? So if you multiply lot, then say for example Reliance lot size is, say for example, is equal to 200, say for example. So if you multiply 20 by 200, it would be around 4000, I think. It would be around 4000. So 4000 rupees would be transferred from this margin of seller to your account. So at the end of the day, this would happen at the end of the day. So this is known as M2M or mark to market. So at the end of every day, the settlement would be done. So you would be gaining 4000 points and the seller would be losing 4000 points. And remember that the next day again, say for example, the margin requirement is 3 lakh. So the seller would have to add another 4000 rupees to meet this margin requirement. Now you have 3 lakhs plus 4000 rupees. This is what M2M means. So this is in the first day, the day that you purchase. What would happen the second day? Let's see. Second day, your buying price won't be 2010. Your buying price would be 2030. So for say for example, on the second day, Reliance price moved from 2020 to say 2050. Another 30 points movement. So on the second day, you would be making a profit of from 2030 to it will also move 30 points, around 30 points. So it would be around 2060. This is futures price. So again, here you will be making a profit of 30 rupees. This is on second day profit. So if you multiply this 30 by 200, it would be 6000. So again, from seller's you would be transferring 6000 rupees to the buyer at the end of the day. At the end of the day, this is known as M2M or mark to market, end of the day. So this process would continue till expiry. So the expiry is, as you know, the last Thursday, similar to our options. Last Thursday of August would be the expiry, last Thursday of September would be the expiry, and last Thursday of October would be the expiry. If the last Thursday is a holiday, just take the previous day, that is Wednesday. So now this would happen. Now imagine that you are going for physical settlement. So for example, you hold your contract and the contract has the expiry has already been over, like last Thursday has finished, and you have still hold the contract. Now in this case, you have to buy the shares at the futures price, right? If you are holding the contract. Now what else you can do? Say for example, after second day, you think that, yeah, I have booked my profit, I have booked 30 rupees, and I have also here booked 20 rupees profit. Now I want to square off my position. Then here you can sell your position. So for example, here you are a buyer one, and here was your contract, and there was a seller one, right? So for example, there is another buyer two available, and he wants to buy this contract. So what you can do? You can sell your position to this buyer two. Now from day 2 onwards, this buyer 2 would be playing with this seller 1. You would be exiting your position. This is known as square off. So you can either square off your position or you can hold your position till expiry. After expiry, you have to buy the shares at the futures price. Remember this, and remember that the margin blocked for both buyer and seller in this case is equal and around 3 lakhs per lot. Now let's see hedging. So hedging is of two types. First is you can hedge your position. You can hedge your position using future. And second is you can hedge future. Right? These are two things. Now first let's see how you can hedge your positions using future. Say for example, you have bought Reliance shares at 2000 rupees. Right? And what there was a very bad news, like very bad news, say for example COVID news, and you know now the price would fall like this, right? Now but you are still expecting that after a fall it might rise again, as Reliance is a very good stock. So what you can do is, say for example you have bought the Reliance shares at this price and currently it is at 2100. And due to COVID news, you are expecting that it would fall and then again it would rise in future. So what can you do is, you can sell a future here. You can sell a future here. So what would happen is that I told you that if the futures price, say for example, if when the current price was 2100, the futures price was say for example 2150. Now if the futures price falls to say for example 2000, 150 points fall, right? So this price would also fall by the around same amount, so it would be around 1950. So now you'll be making a profit in future of 150 points, the same that you are losing on this shares that you hold, right? You have hold shares at 2000, right? So you are fearing that it might fall from 2100 to anywhere, you never know. So you can sell a future and book this profit, the fall that the Reliance is making. Now after you know that it would now rise, then you can square off your position here. You can buy a future here, buy a future, right? So you basically squaring off your position, square off, right? Once you do that, so you are essentially booking this like false profit, and then it would again rise and your shares would be capturing that profit. So this is known as hedging your positions using future in adverse market scenarios, right? Just like here we had a COVID bad news, any news can be there. So futures is used for this purpose. Next, how to hedge future to get margin benefits, to get margin benefits. I told you that for future both buyer and seller have to block 3 lakhs per lot margin, which is very huge. Similar to our options case, how did we hedge our position to get minimal margin? So in the same way we can do in futures. Say for example, you have bought a futures, or say for example you have sold a future at 2100. Now if the price rises from 2100 to 2200, say for example, then you'd be incurring severe losses in future. So that's why the broker is charging you high margin requirements, that is 3 lakhs. So what you can do is, you can say for example at 2200 you can buy a call here, right? Option one. So you can buy a call option here. So as I said that this is out of the money call option, so it would be around say for example Rs 5 rupees per share. So you can now imagine that just by giving 5 rupees per share, so lot size would be say 200, then you would be giving around only 1000 rupees. So using 1000 rupees, now your margin blocked would be significantly less, like by 3 around. So it would be around only 1 lakh rupees. So this is how you can hedge your future position to get margin benefits. Remember that if you have sold a future here, then you can buy a call option here. so that your position would be hedged and you would be getting margin benefits. Okay, and if you have bought a future, say for example, if you have bought a future, at say for example you have bought the future at say for example at 2000 price, then you are thinking that price would go up, but it might fall back also. You would be incurring huge losses. So in that case, you can just buy a put option. So for example, around at 1700 or something out of the money. So it would cost you around very less, like Rs. 5 per share, right? So this is how hedging is done. This is known as one kind of hedging for buying position, and this is hedging for selling position, right? I hope this concept is clear. In the next video, we'll be with some new concept. Till then, take care. Thank you. Bye bye.